Hello friends, today I'm going to teach large numbers. So there are two kinds of large numbers, one we follow in India and the other one we follow internationally. So today I'm going to take up Indian system of numeration. Okay, so let's begin. Now tell me, how many of you live in joint family? Many of us live in joint family. So what happens in joint family? There are small families which live in a big family. So same way we have large numbers, in which we have small families, and these small families are known as period. Let's see. If I have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 8, 7, 3. If I have this big large family or joint family, okay? In this family, we have small families. One is my family, the other one is my uncle's family, the next is my aunt's family, and this is my grandparents' family. The way different families are living together, they are segregated through rooms. So we segregate this large number through commas. Okay? We segregate large numbers through commas. So 2, 3, comma, 4, 5, comma, 6, 9, comma, 8, 7, 3. Now how did I put commas? So what are the members of the family? What are these families called? Now we are going to learn that. Now let's see this large number. We have this big large number. Now how to read this large number? And what are these families called? So now first we will see this family. These families are called periods, period order. They are called period order. Now this is one's period order. The way I say it is my family, it is one's family. Okay? In my family, members are me, myself, my mother, my father. The same way, in this family, members are ones, tens, and hundreds. So, members are ones, tens, and hundreds. In one's family, members are ones, tens, and hundreds. Now, next family. Whose family is this? It's my uncle's family. Members are uncle and aunt, okay? So, let's see. So, this family is thousands family. This family is thousands family. And members are thousands and 10,000, okay? Then, this is my aunt's family. Members are aunt and uncle. Now, here in large number, what family is this? This is lakhs family. Okay, and members are lakhs and 10 lakhs. Okay, then here it is grandparents family. Members are grandfather and grandmother. Similar manner, this is my crores family. And members are crore and 10 crore and crore. Okay, so these are called periods. These families, that is ones, thousands, lakhs and crores, are called periods. Okay, ones period, thousands period, lakhs period and crores period. And member of ones period, ones, tens, hundred. Member of thousands period, thousand, 10,000. Lakhs period, lakhs, 10 lakh and crores period, crore and 10 crore. Now whenever we read the number, then we read the number and the family's name also. The way, see, if I say 23, the 23 and the family name is crore. Okay, so 23 crore, 45 lakh, 69,873. Only one's family, we don't write the family's name in it. Okay, in one's period, we don't write the period's name. So, if you read this number all together, how will you say this? 23 crore, 45 lakh, 69,873. Now, before beginning the number names, I would like to share few rules of writing number names. Whenever you are writing number names, first thing, never start with capital. They are not a sentence. Okay? So, never start with capital. Never end with full stop. No capital, no full stop. We are going to begin with small letter and we are not going to write full stop in it. Second thing, in compound numbers like 23. 23 is a compound number, so we will write a hyphen in between. When you are writing 23, 20 hyphen and 3. Okay, no full stop. Okay, so second thing, this is the second rule of this writing number names. We never write and. 23 crore 45 lakh 69,000 and 873. We will not write. We will just write 873. So let's revise. No capital, no full stop, no and what? You will write hyphen between compound numbers. Now we will read few numbers. So before reading the number, what is the major step here? Yes, marking of periods. When we are putting these commas, na, these comma, when we are putting the comma, that is called marking of period. So let's see how to mark periods. For that, you should remember the place values. Place values of the numbers. The way I told you, ones, tens, hundreds. Let's revise. Ones, tens and hundreds. These place values are done. One period of ones is done. When one period is over, mark the period. This putting comma is known as marking the period. Then thousand, 10,000. Thousand family is done, thousand period is done. Mark the period. Then lakh, 10 lakh. This lakh period is done. Mark the period. And crore. Okay, so last digit is crore. So we'll start from crores family. So 4 crore, 29 lakh, 87,634. Ones ke saath aap, you will not write the period name. Okay, now let's mark the period once again. You will say with me, say ones, tens, hundreds. Once period is over, comma. Then thousand, 10,000. Thousand period is over, comma. Lakh, 10 lakh. Lakh period is over, comma. Crore, 10 crore. So let's read the number together. 29 crore 73 lakh 487. If there is no number in any place, you will skip the place. Okay. Then again, let's begin. Ones, tens, hundreds, comma. Thousand, 10,000, comma. Lakh, 10 lakh, comma. Crore, 10 crore. So it is 90 crore 80 lakh 70,009. So I hope you understood how to read the number. Once you have understood how to read the number, you can easily write the number name. Okay. So in this number, first of all, what you are supposed to do? Yes, we have to mark the periods. Okay, let's mark the periods. Ones, tens, hundreds, comma, thousand, 10,000, comma, lakh, 10 lakh, comma, crore, 10 crore. So let's read the number together. 59 crore, 87 lakh, 63,248. Let's write the numbering. So 59. Will I start with capital letter? No, I will start with small letter. 59. Compound number is there, that is why we will put hyphen. 59 crore. One rule I missed. We will never write S. Crores nahi likhenge. Crores we write in place value. Okay. Here in number name, we never write S. Okay. 59 crore 87. 80 hyphen 7 lakh, no S. 63,248. So 59 crore 87 lakh 63,248. This way you are going to write the number name. Okay, now let's see this number. What we are going to do? First we'll mark the periods. Ones, tens, hundreds, comma, thousand, 10,000, comma, lakh, 10 lakh, comma, crore, 10 crore. Let's read the number. 79 crore, 78 lakh, 46,314. So let's write the number name. What are the rules? No full stop, no capital, no S, no and. Okay? So we will write number in here. 79 crore, 78 lakh, 46,314. So I hope you now you have understood how to write the number name. Now let's proceed to place value, face value and period. Now we are going to learn how we are going to find out the place value, face value and the period of a particular number. Now see, suppose if I have this number and I have to find out the place value, face value and period of this number 4. Okay, so first we will see ones, tens, hundred, thousand. So this number is a thousands place. Okay, and the period is thousand only, thousands. Okay, so how are we going to write place value? So, 4, place value kya hogi? Kis place par hai? Thousand ki place par hai, so we will write 4 thousands or we can write in both ways, either in number or in words. But whenever you are writing in words, here you are going to write S. Whenever we are writing place value, we put S with it. Okay. Now face value. Face value of any number remains the same, whether it is at any place. Okay. Ye 4 yahan par hai, agar yahan par hai, yahan par, anywhere it is, the place, the face value of the number will remain the same. Okay. 4 ki face value will remain 4 only. Now period. What is the period of this 4? Family is this. Which period is this? Yes, it is thousands. So you will write thousands. Period is thousands. Okay. Now we have this number 9. If I have 9. Okay. So 9 is at which place? Ones, tens. 9 is at which place? Tens place. Okay. So what you will write? The place value of 9 is 9 tens or 90. Okay, this is the place value. Don't get confused with period or place value. Okay, whenever it is asked period, then it is different. Okay, face value remains the same, 9 will remain 9 only, and the period. Now what is the period of this 9? Okay, it comes in which period, which family? My family. Okay, so same way it is coming in one's family. It is coming in once family. So period is once. Most of the children get confused. They write tens only. No, the period is once. It is the family name. Once. Okay. And it is a member of the family. Same way we will see 8. Okay. This 8 is at which place? This 8 is at 10 lakhs place. Ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000 lakhs, 10 lakhs. It is at 10 lakhs place. Okay. So here place value will be 10 lakhs. 8, 10 lakhs. Okay. Or in numbers you write 8 and you will find the number. See the number of digits after it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 8 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 zeros. So 8, 10 lakhs or this way. In place value, I am repeating, you will write S. Then face value, number remains the same. Now period. Period is what? Period is lakhs. So you will write lakhs over there. Now if you have to write down the expanded form. Now see expanded form. 3840075. If you have to expand this number, okay, how are you going to expand? Expansion we can do in two ways, one in numbers and others in words. Okay, how we are going to do in numbers? We are writing the place values. Place values, I told you, we can do in two ways, in numbers and in words, both in the similar manner. When you are expanding, expanding also you can do in the same way. What is expansion? You are writing the place values of the number. When you combine them, you will get the same number again. Okay, so you are writing in a way that the number doesn't change, because here we have equals to sign. So you are expanding the number only. So number is not changing. It is just in expanded way it is written. So first we will do in words. 3. And what is the place value? This is ones. This is thousands. And this is lakhs. Okay. So 3. Which place? Lakhs. 10 lakhs. 3. 10 lakhs. We are just writing the place values. Then 8. Lakhs plus 4, then it is 10,000's place. 4, 10, thousands. Then, see, zeros we don't expand, we skip zeros. Okay, so now 7 is at which place? 1s and 10s. 10s place, so you will write 7 10s plus 5 1s. Okay. Clear? Now, let's see one more number. Okay, so let's read the number 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore, 10 crore. So this is crores place, this is lakhs place, this is thousands, this is 1s. So this is crores period, lakhs period, thousands period and ones period. Okay. Now let's see. We start from crores. So 2 is at 10 crores place. 2, 10 crores plus 9 crores plus 7, 10 lakhs. It is at lakhs place plus 5. Lakhs, then 0 we skip as I told you, then it is thousands place, 4, thousands plus 9, 1s. This way we expand the number in words. Now let's see expansion in numbers. The same way we will do, we will see place values 1s, this is 1s period, this is thousands period. This is lakhs period, okay? 1. The best part, how do we do? It is a 10 lakhs place, okay? So, 1 and 10 lakhs, how many zeros are we going to write? So, we'll see the number of digits after it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just 6 zeros after it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Then 0, we don't expand. Then 7 is a 10,000 space. 7 and how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, then 8 and 3 zeros, then 6 and 2 zeros, then 3, 1 0 and 9. This way we expand in word, in numbers, sorry. Then 5 and how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Mark the periods. Then 8. How many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Mark the periods. Then 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. 9, 1, 2, 3, 1. So this way you are going to expand any number in numbers. Now we see the standard form. Standard form means short form of any number. Now the expansion is given to you. One is in words, one is in number and other one is in words. It's given to you. Now how are you going to do? First, the best part, how are you going to do? To see the biggest number, the first number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 digits are there all together, make 9 dashes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay? So, what you see, it's a trick. Easily you can do it, okay? Now it is at which place? 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh crore, 10 crore. It is a 10 crore space. So we will write it at 10 crores place, okay? Then 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh crore. Next number is at crores place. Or you can see at which in the place it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 place. Okay. The next number is at 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth place per hai. So here 1, 2, 3 and fourth place where you write the number. It is at thousands place. Now fourth place is thousands place. Now this number is at 1, 2 and third place per. So you will write it third place. And this is first place. Okay, now rest of the dashes you will fill with zeros. Got it? Easy. See, you can do it with place values also, but this way I always find it easy. Now here, again, the biggest place value is 10 crore. 1, 10, 100. 1000, 10,000. Lakh, 10 lakh. Crore, 10 crore. We will make the dashes. Now we will fill the dashes. 4, 10 crores. So 10 crores place is this. 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh crores and 10 crores. This is my 10 crores place. Let's write place values. 10 lakh, lakh, 10,000, 1000, 100, tens and ones. Okay. So 10 crores is this. Then 3 crores. Then 2 lakhs. So 2 lakhs comes here. 10 lakh place is empty. Then 5, 10 thousands. Then 4 tens, tens place it's coming and 9 ones. Now whatever places are empty, please put zeros. So you will get your number. So I hope you understood this. Now we will do ordering. Before ordering, first we will learn how to compare two numbers. Okay. If I have 298763 and you have to put this sign greater than, lesser than or equals to sign. Okay. And then 1297625. So how do we compare? First rule of comparing. First you will count the number of digits. Okay. We will see number of digits here and number of digits here. Here how many digits I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here how many I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Greater the number of digits, greater the number. So my crocodile's mouth will open at bigger number. Okay. But if I have this. If I have this number. First we will count the number of digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So number of digits are same. Then what we are going to do? Now we will see from the first zero, the biggest place value, okay? 2, 2 same, 9, 9 same, then third digit 8, 8 is same, then fourth digit 7, 7 is same. Now let's see the fifth digit, it is 6 and it is 3 here. So which one is bigger? So we always start from the bigger place value, okay? And keep on comparing. This way we compare and find the bigger number. Now, if you have to arrange a number in particular order, say ascending order or descending order. Like if I have these numbers and I have to arrange them in ascending order. Now what is ascending order? Ascending order means arranging numbers from small to big. Okay, how are we going to arrange them? So when I taught you comparing, that time I told you first we will see the number of digits. Okay. So how many digits we have here? Biggest 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Biggest place value is lakh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 digits here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Here I have only 5 digits. That means smaller the lesser the number of digits, smaller the number. So here this number is first. Okay. Now in these three numbers, number of digits are same. So we'll start comparing from first digit. That means biggest place value. 3, 3, 3. 3's are same. Then we will see the second digit. 8, 8 and 7. Which one is smaller? 7 is smaller. Okay. Then we will come now. these two are left. Okay, now we have to compare these two. So 8 second digit ho gaya, third digit 7 is same, then fourth digit 6 and 2. Which one is greater? 6. And which one is smaller? 2. So it comes at third place and here it comes at fourth place. Now you have got your order. How you are going to arrange them? In ascending order, small to big. Okay, 3, 8, 7, 6, 2. Now which sign are you going to put? Always remember, this is your crocodile's mouth. And crocodile ko bada bada khana achcha lagta hai, chota khana nahi achcha lagta. So this crocodile's mouth always opens at the bigger number. This is smaller number. Okay, so bigger big number is this. So you will put this sign. 3, 7, 8, 6, 2, 1. Then 3, 8, 7, 2, 6, 1. And then 3, 8, 7, 6, 2, 1. So this way you will arrange them in ascending order. Now let's see descending order. Descending order is what? Descending order means big to small. So first we have to mark the bigger number and then smaller numbers. Okay. Now the same thing. First we will see the number of digits. Bigger the number of digits, bigger the number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5 means smaller number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means this is the smallest number. So, ye last mein aayega hamara. Okay. Then we have to compare these three. We have to find out the biggest number. 4, 4, 4. First digit is same. 0, 0, 0. Second digit is same. 0, 0, 0. Third digit is same. Then 9, 8, 9. Now these two are 9. So first we will see these two. Then 9 is same. Then 8 is same. Now 7 and 1. That means 7 is bigger. So this comes at first place and this comes at second place. Then this obviously third place. Fourth I'm already marked kar chuke. So let's write. 4, 0, 0, 9, 8, 7. Now crocodile's mouth will open at bigger number. Then second 4, 0, 0, 9, 8, 1. Then 4, 0, 0, 8, 9, 7. Then 4, 0, 0, 9, 8. This is the way you will arrange the number in descending order. Now we have successor and predecessor. Now what is successor? Successor means a number ahead. That means 1 plus to the number. If you have 4, the successor will be 5. If you have 7, successor will be 8. So 1 number ahead. Yani ki aapne number mein 1 plus kar diya. If you add 1 to the number, you'll get the successor. In the same way, predecessor, what is predecessor? A number before. That means a number which comes before. That means you subtract 1 to the number and then you'll get the predecessor. If you have 10, what will be the predecessor? 9. And what will be the successor? 11. So successor plus 1 and predecessor minus 1. Okay. Now let's see. If I have this number, 3,89,63,408. If you have to find out the predecessor. Predecessor means a number before. So first you will see the digit at 1's place. In 1's place I have 8. So 8, the number before to 8 is 7. So rest of the number will remain same. Only 1's place number you will change. And here it will become 3,89,63,407. So you just subtracted 1 from 8 and you will get the predecessor. And if I say successor, you will add 1 to 8. When you are adding 1 to 8, what it becomes? 9. So it's easy. 3,89,63,409. So you will see the 1's place. Okay. In 1's place for predecessor, you will subtract 1. And for successor, you will add 1. Okay. Now if I have 59,79,9,999. Now again I will see my 1's place. It's 9. So what will be the predecessor when you are subtracting 1 from 9? It becomes 8. So it is easy. Rest of the number will remain same. 59,79,9,998. So predecessor will be this. You just subtracted 1 to it. But if you are adding 1 to it for successor, if you want to find out the successor, you have to add 1 to it. When you are adding 1 to 9, what it becomes? It becomes 10. When it becomes 10, you cannot write 2 digit number, you cannot write 1 and 0. So this one you will give to next digit. Okay, and this next digit is also 9. To 9, if it gets 1, it will become 10. It will become 10, so it will give 1 to this number. It will become again 10. Then this number 10 and this number here. So it will become 59,79,10,000. Actually, it is just an addition of 1 in a number. And that you can do because addition you already know. So you can add 1 to a number and you will get the successor of this number. Now you see this number, 23,14,89,000. Okay, now predecessor. Predecessor means minus 1. When you are subtracting 1 from this number, what you get? You subtract it. 1 is 0. You cannot subtract 1 from 0. So you have to borrow 1. This cannot give, this cannot give. So 8, 9, 9, 10. You know the subtraction now? 10 minus 1 is 9, 9, 9, 8, 8. So it will become 23,14,88,999. So this 9,000, the predecessor of this 9,000 will become 8,999 as you subtracted 1 from it. Okay. Now successor of this number, again 1's place 0. You can easily add 1 to it. If you add 1 to 0, then it will become 1. So rest of the number will remain same. 23,14,89,001. So successor, you are just adding 1 to the number and it will become this. Formation of the greatest and the smallest number using the digits. Okay. Now these digits have been given to us and we have to form greatest and the smallest number using the digits. Now we are going to use these digits only once. Okay. Now if I have this 3, 8, 9, 7, 1, 2. Okay, if I have this, so it's very easy. Greatest number, just write in the descending order. 9, 8, 5, 3, 2, 1. Okay, and smallest number, just ascending order. 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 9. Now one thing, you know, children do this mistake a lot. They put comma after every digit. Because here I have put comma after every digit, so they also do the same. But you know, when you are putting comma after every digit, that means you are writing the separate digits. Here, you are just writing the commas for any system of numeration, either international or Indian. You cannot put commas after every digit. If you put commas after every digit of number, here you have made 6 separate digits, 6 separate numbers. Okay? So 9, 8, 5, 3, 1, 2. Here you will just mark the periods. If you are writing, if you are putting commas, you will just mark the periods. In the same way here, just mark the period. When you are writing the greatest number, you are writing in descending order. And when you are writing the smallest number, you are writing in ascending order. But, you know, here when you have this 0 in it, then smallest number changes a little. You know, pehle greatest number to hum easily likh sakte, greatest number chaliye likh lete. 9, 7, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Greatest number is easy to write, okay? But when you are writing smaller numbers, when you are writing the smallest number, you cannot write 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 9. If you are writing this, you know, what happens? If you put a 0 before a number, it has no significance, no value of it. But here 0 we have to use because you are making 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 digit number. Okay. If you are using 0 before a number, then it doesn't have any significance. Usi koi value nahi hai. Then we will not consider it. If you write 0, if you don't write 0, it doesn't have any value. That is why this way of writing is wrong. We don't write like this. 0 we never write in front. Because if I write 0 in front, it will not have any value and my one digit will be lesser there. We write 0 after the second smallest digit. That means 1, 0, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 9. This way I will write. Okay, where I am writing 0 at the second place, not the first place, but the second place, as 0 doesn't have any significance in the first, in the beginning, if you write, it doesn't have any significance. Now, let's see this number here. See, this number also has 0. So, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 2, 1. Now, are we writing comma after 1 and 0? Are we writing comma after every digit? No, we will not write comma after every digit, but we will write comma after place value. See, we will just mark the periods in this. Okay, now we have this in this 1 and 0. 0 will come at the second place. Okay, 1, 0, then 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So, this is the smallest digit formed by these digits. Okay. I hope you have understood the Indian system of numeration. In the next video, I will teach you international system of numeration. So, by the time you practice this, watch the video carefully and understand all the topics. Okay. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.